but my experience with COVID began in November of last year. It's hard to peg, but you know, initially, I just don't feel well, you know, a little cough, but then, you know, things started to progress to cough, worsening, fever, and that's when I realized something was out of the ordinary. I had severe shortness of breath, and I made a decision to go to the hospital because I knew, you know, things were dire. 2 days later, I ended up being placed on mechanical ventilation and then transferred down to Geisinger Medical Center for further care. I ended up being on ECMO for well over 1,600 hours. I was hypoxic and ultimately ended up receiving a bilateral lung transplant. That experience overall has been difficult, mainly because of the deconditioning, more importantly, the effect it had on my family. I feel obviously better than I did, which is a good thing. However, I am still having residual effects. The residual effects that are probably the most difficult are the deconditioning and the weakness that I continue to have are the most difficult parts. There is a significant amount of pain also involved, not just from the surgery, but just from the whole experience. So pain is a constant issue. I received the vaccine 3 months after my transplant. I believe the vaccine is probably the best studied vaccine in the history of mankind. It is very effective. I got sick before the vaccine was available. Had I received the vaccine, I might not be talking to you about my experience right now. So I believe everyone should receive the vaccine. Because not only are you doing it for yourself, you're also doing it for those around you.